One of the missions of the Naval Observatory is to measure the orientation of the Earth in space. And to do that, you need a reference system in which to measure that orientation. We use VLBI, and especially the VLBA, to look at quasars, which are so far away, they basically form points in the sky that don't move because they're so far away. There's no motion to these. If you chose to look at stars that are, say, in our own galaxy, all the stars in our galaxy are whipping around and moving around, and so it's difficult to use those as an actual reference frame. We try to look at a distributed amount of quasars on the sky, equally distributed on the sky, and then we take these and we form a frame out of them. Once you have that frame, that stable frame, then you can measure the rotation of the Earth within that frame. The more accurately you can measure these points on the sky, the more accurately you can develop a reference frame that we need to measure the orientation of the Earth in space. The VLBA provides the most accuracy that you can get by any technique. The fact that it's an array of 10 homogeneous antennas make it the perfect thing to do. The astrometry that we need to do, Earth orientation is the transformation between what's called the celestial reference frame, the coordinates of these quasars, and also what's called the terrestrial reference frame, which is a reference frame formed by all the positions of these antennas on the surface of the Earth. Once you know the celestial reference frame, the Earth orientation, and the terrestrial reference frame, then you can start doing lots of interesting geophysical science. You can measure things like the height of the sea surface. The ultimate goal is to measure sea surface height down to the 1 millimeter level. And then you can do lots of interesting science about learning about global climate change. What's the distribution of water that's underneath the surface of the land? How does ice loading affect you in the wintertime, or hydrological water loading affect you in the summertime? You can also do lots of plate tectonics. You have these ground stations, and you have these this reference frame in the sky. You can measure how these ground stations are moving, and from that motion, you can determine, you know, the plate tectonics, which way are certain plates moving relative to one another, as long as you can put stations that are close by near the fault lines.